fact, look, here's the deal. Here's the deal.
It looks, you know, it's like you don't have any more backbone than Trump does. Oh.
Any other questions?
Ladies and gentlemen, they gave me a list here. The first person I was instructed to call on was Kelly O'Donnell of NBC. I'll take your questions, and as usual, folks, they gave me a list of the people I'm going to call on. I talked about the proposition that certain critical infrastructure should be off limits to attack, period, by cyber or any other means. I gave them a list. If I'm not mistaken, I don't have it in front of me, 16 specific entities, 16 defined as critical infrastructure under U.S. policy. Okay, hang on. Sorry. Oh, Sing Ming, Ms. Kim.
Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it.
And may God protect those in the path of the storm, and God willing, we'll get through this sooner than later. But don't kid yourself. This is going to take a lot of resources, a little bit of luck. My grandfather would say, the grace of God and the goodwill of the neighbors. By the way, look out for your neighbors. If you're in the region, look out for your neighbors. So thank you very much, and thank you, Commissioner. I really think it all works. I'm not supposed to take any questions, but go ahead.
Mr. President, on Afghanistan?
I'm not going to answer Afghanistan now. Now, I'm supposed to stop and walk out of the room here. God bless you all, and may God protect our troops. Thank you.
History
repeats itself. Try and you succeed.
And so, I'm going to say something outrageous. I have never been particularly poor at calculating how to get things done in the United States Senate. So the best way to get something done, if it holds near and dear to you that you like to be able to, anyway, we're ready to get a lot done.
Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream.
Brock and I think it's a right for people that bad at health care. For people that bad at health care.
You're the best around, and nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
These headlines from Axios and other websites point out that Biden's plan is dull by design. So is he making the news boring again? Let me answer all of those questions the way Biden would. Come on, man. No way.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
But I tell you, if you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
Americans have lost their confidence in President Biden and their optimism for the country. At least they have right now. Just 22% of adults say we're headed in the right direction. A shocking 71% say we're on the wrong track. And that includes a near majority of Democrats who are saying that. President Biden's approval rating stands at a dismal 42% versus 54% who disapprove.
Do you think so?
Fight to the end, cause your life will depend on the strength that you have inside you. I gotta be proud, standing out in the crowd with the odds in the game by you. Try your best to win them all, and one day time will tell when you're the one left standing there.
I'll lead an effective strategy to mobilize true international effort to pressure. True international effort to pressure.
Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best.
We have this notion that somehow if you're poor, you cannot do it. Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids. Wealthy kids, black kids, Asian kids. No, I really mean it, but think how we think about it.
Not a joke. Think about it. We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by you know the thing.
And the contrast on display tonight
was so stark. I mean, those lights that are just shooting out from the Lincoln Memorial along the reflecting pool, it's like almost extensions of Joe Biden's arms embracing America. It was a moment where the new president came to town and sort of convened the country in this moment of remembrance, outstretching his arms, outstretching his arms.
And perhaps, most cruelly of all, if Donald Trump has his way, the complications from COVID-19, which are well beyond what they should be. It's estimated that 200 million people have died, probably by the time I finish this talk.
My name is Joe Biden. I love ice cream.
You're fired.